Darling, it certainly is good to have you home for a change.
Honey, you have no idea how nice it is to be here and relax with you.
That's the nicest thing you could have said.
And that dinner you cooked tonight, that's the best I've ever tasted.
From anybody else, I'd consider that a compliment. But since you're the great Dick Tracy and never have time to come home for meals, the only thing you can compare my cooking with is the hamburgers and hot dogs and coffee that you manage to eat between cases.
Now, Tess, I think you're exaggerating a little bit.
Exaggerating? Why, even when we went away on our honeymoon, you left me. For 3 days, I didn't know where you were.
Well, could I help it that Killer Randon started operations right where we were?
Well, I certainly hope you're going to stay home tonight.
I am, honey. And just to prove it, I'm going to get rid of this gun.
At least that's a step in the right direction.
Are we expecting company tonight, Tess?
No, I wonder who it could be.
Well, it's probably Sam Ketchum.
If it's anybody from police headquarters, believe me, I'm going to make life miserable for them.
Now, Tess.
Yes?
Is Mr. Dick Tracy in?
Yes, who's calling?
I'm Badoo with the fingerprint department down at headquarters.
Oh, no. Don't tell me it's business again.
Mrs. Tracy, believe me, this isn't for business. It's a pleasure.
This way, please. Two men from headquarters to see you.
Hey, copper.
Tracy, you won't be needing this gun any longer. You're coming with us.
You killed my husband!
Take it easy, lady. You'll live longer.
Mrs. Tracy, your husband ain't dead yet. He'll be coming to in a few minutes. When he does, he's coming along with us. Valuable thing I have. Right, Moat?
Yeah. You got $5,000 for him even before you kill him.
That's right, Tracy. And I get $5,000 more when they see you're dead.
Gosh, flat up. $10,000. That's not bad, isn't it?
You know something, Moat? I don't think I'm a very good businessman.
What do you mean?
Well, I was offered $10,000 for the job and I took it. You know? If they wanted to pay that much right off, maybe they'd be willing to go higher. Hey, copper, cut the noise. I'm trying to think.
Yeah, Tracy. Do not bother flat up, see? Ah, look, boss. Who strangled Tracy with his own tie?
Now, let him alone. After all, I got $5,000 for him before I even saw him.
Copper, you're pretty lucky. What are you going to do, flat up?
I got a good idea. Flat top.
This is my private phone, Flat Top. How many times have I told you never to use it?
I got news for you, Nam Gib. I got Tracy. Just picked him up less than 15 minutes ago.
Good. Well, I've got another $5,000 for you when I know he's dead.
Nam Gib, I've been doing a lot of thinking. Now, you're the head of a big syndicate, and I know who your partners are. And I'm telling their names out loud so Dick Tracy can hear me. But first, I want to tell him your phone number is 5704. You got that, copper? 5704. My name's Nam Gib. He's the head of the syndicate. And his partners are Rentnoy and Faber.
What are you trying to pull, Flat Top? Have you really got Dick Tracy there?
Take it easy, Nam Gib. Hold it a minute. Hey, Mo, take a gag off Tracy. I want him to say a couple of words to my friend here. Hey, come on, Tracy, say something. Hey, talk.
Look, Fat Top, you may kill me.
But you'll never get away with it. No cop killer ever does.
That's enough out of you. Put the gag back on, Mose. Yeah? Do you hear that? There's only one guy in the whole world that talks like that.
Oh, all right, Fat Top. You've convinced me you've got Tracy there. And you'll get the other $5,000 when you prove that he's dead.
But $5,000 ain't enough. I want $45,000 more. I've decided this job is worth at least $50,000. And I'm sure you can afford it.
Why, you dirty crook, that's nothing but blackmail.
Of course it's blackmail. But if I let Tracy go, I've still got the $5,000. And they let me go because I told them your phone number and your name. And I'm going to give him enough more information to put you out of business, see?
No, Flat Top. Use your head. Take it easy. Everything is going to be all right. Now, just cool down, Flat Top. I'll see if I can't raise the $45,000. Just give me your address and phone number. I'll come right over and we'll discuss the whole thing.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not going to send a couple of guys up here to try to take care of me, too. I'll call you back in a couple of hours. And you better have the dough. Well, you're worth $50,000 to me. Promote. Be sure and treat our guest nice and gentle.
Sure, boss. You know, he looks to me, he's a little bit tired. And he could use some sleep.
Well, why don't you see he takes a little nap?
Sure, boss.
That's pretty good. Pretty good.
I'll do anything I can to help.
That's fine. Now, first of all, some of them bring along a few pictures here in a little while, and I want you to look them over. Then we'll start on the trail.
Get here.
Oh, thanks, Gillis. Here's the pictures right now. Will you look those over?
This is one of the men.
Good. That's the lead we needed. Tess, you wait here. I'll go to Chief Patton's office and get things rolling. His name is Moat. Tess just identified him. He's got a long criminal record. Oh, he's one of the pair that took Tracy, all right.
Well, they won't get away with it. I've already sent out a general alarm. Now I'll put out this description. That ought to get results.
That's not enough, Pat. I'm going downtown myself. I got a few sources I want to tap. Hey, pal, you seen Moat around lately?
Moat? Never heard of him.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Well, you should run into him. Tell him Muggsy's looking for him.
Muggsy? Who's Muggsy?
Me. And tell him I want my dough.
What'd he do, Welsh on you?
You can say that again.
Well, I don't know him, but I heard that if you want Moat, look for Flat Top.
Flat Top, eh? Thanks.
No, he ain't got here yet. He went out to the track. Yeah.
You got good coffee.
Yeah. Refill?
Ah. Maybe you can give me something else.
Yeah?
Yeah, I just got in town. I'm looking for an old pal. He tell me he thinks your food ain't bad. Comes here pretty regular.
I got lots of customers. Who is he?
Flat Top.
Flat Top? Where do you know him from?
Big house. 3 years ago. We done a stretch together.
Oh, yeah. Flat Top told me about that vacation. Now, he ain't been in since yesterday morning. He had a call and ran out. So he had a big deal on.
Okay. I'll be back. See you.
Extra, extra, get your paper here. What do you read? Extra, get your paper here. Yes, sir, get your paper here. Extra, extra, get your latest paper here. What do you read? Extra. Extra, get your paper here. Extra, extra, extra. Paper, mister?
How's business, Timmy?
Mr. Ketchum. I've been keeping my nose clean, Mr. Ketchum. I ain't done nothing honest.
I know. I'm glad of it, Timmy. I just stopped by for a little favor.
Well, gee, Mr. Ketchum, anything I can do, I'll be glad.
Just information. A lot of people go by here, and you're in a spot to hear what's going on.
I ain't mixed up in nothing.
I believe you. Maybe some of the boys buy papers here. Maybe they talk.
About what?
Oh, what's this deal that Flat Top is on?
Flat Top? Honest, I don't know.
Whatever you know, spill it.
Please, Mr. Ketchum, only one thing. It's with this guy, a big-time operative by the name of Namgib.
Namgib, eh? Thanks, Timmy. I won't forget you.
Extra, extra, what do you read? We got it.
You know, I've always wanted to have a nice, friendly conversation with a copper.
What do you want to talk about? Music? Politics? Books? Or killings?
You got a great sense of humor there.
Thanks. Now, what do you want?
Nothing. Nothing much. I just thought I'd tell you a few things you'd like to know about. Seeing as how I'm gonna kill you, it doesn't matter very much.
That should be very interesting.
Well, I used to have a gang in Cleveland. Working slot machines. A lot of dough in that. Of course, we got knocked off a couple of times. It cost a little dough, but we got out of it all right.
Gosh, Flat Top, I didn't know you'd done all them things. Gee, you really get around.
Yes, you really do get around. But you've done so much wrong that your time should be up pretty soon.
Speaking of time.
Why don't you go on Lampkin and see if he got your door for you?
That's a good idea. He said if he could get it, he'd have it in a couple of hours.
Well, if you're going to kill me, do you mind if I have a pencil and a piece of paper?
I'd like to write my wife, Tess, a farewell note.
Flat Top, that's the silliest thing I ever heard of. You aren't going to let him do it, are you?
Sure. His wife seemed like a good kid.
Yeah, but she's Dick Tracy's wife.
Untie him. I'll get him a pencil and paper and let him write.
Thanks.
I'm a little nervous.
Okay, go ahead and write your letter any way you want.
Chief Patton. Sam Ketchum, Chief Patton. Come in, Patton.
Patton speaking. Come in, Sam.
Pat, I just heard from Tracy. A code message. Flat Top's got him.
Flat Top? Where?
Tracy doesn't know where it is. He told me it was too dangerous to call him back.
Did he give you any lead at all?
Yes. The name of the man behind Flat Top. A big shot. Namgib. And that tallies with information I just uncovered.
I'll concentrate all available men on it. We'll pick up this Namgib. Make him talk.
No, Pat, don't. I want you to call everybody off. They may scare Flat Top and make it worse for Tracy. Besides, Tracy told me Namgib was meeting with Flat Top to make a payoff.
What's your next move?
I'm going to find Namgib and tail him. He'll lead us to Tracy. Out.
Hello, Namgib. This is Flat Top.
Yeah? I've got the $45,000 for you right here.
Yeah, when do I get the dough?
Just as soon as you've taken care of Dick Tracy.
I'm not killing Tracy till I get it.
And I'm not giving you any part of this 45 grand until Tracy is dead.
Put out the stolen, you phony, or I'll turn Tracy loose.
No, 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 don't do that. Don't do that. Now, use your head. I'll bring the money right over myself. Just tell me where you are.
It looks like we're stuck. I don't kill Tracy unless I get the dough. You don't give me the dough unless you know he's dead. I'll tell you what you do.
You come over to 53 Peffin. Come alone and give three quick knocks. It's apartment 4. If anybody's with you, the deal's off.
I'll be right over.
You better hurry up, because I'm not killing Tracy till you get here.
That's just the way I want it.
That letter yet, Tracy?
Yes, almost.
Well, you'd better hurry up. You've got about 15 minutes to live, 20 at the most. Because as soon as that dough gets here, it's goodbye, Dick Tracy.
Are you going to kill him yourself, or are you going to let me do it, Flat Top?
No, I'm going to do it. Ain't that I'm getting paid. It's that I want to.
And if you're a real nice guy, I'll kill you quick. Otherwise, you'd die real slow.
You better start packing our things. Because if we get that dough, we're going to have to leave this town pretty fast. Especially after we bump off Mr. Tracy.
Well, you haven't killed me yet, Flat Top. And when you do, you're bound to be caught.
There's only one mistake I may have made, and that's not shooting your wife. She's a witness, you know. You ought to be very grateful I left her alone.
Why not go back there and knock her off, too?
You know, there's one thing I've never done in my life, and that's shoot a woman. I don't intend to unless I'm forced to do it.
Okay, play it the way you want it.
That's the way I want to play it. Now, hurry up and get packed.
Laptop, you say Nambigger is the head of this whole syndicate?
That's right. He's been organizing the top criminal outfits in this town for the past 3 weeks. Every time he got things rolling, you broke it up.
Well, if I've caused him that much trouble and cost him so much money, why don't you try holding him up for $100,000 instead of $50,000?
Yeah. Hey, you may have something there. Yeah, what do you think, Mo?
Sure. Wouldn't hurt to try.
I'll see what Nam Gibbs says when he gets here. Just don't move, copper. Hey, Mo, go to the door and open it slow. And keep that gun leveled. All right, shut it. Are you alone?
I was expecting a reception something like this. Guns and everything. Oh, yeah. I've decided to live a little while longer, so I came alone.
But that's real smart of you.
In my business, you don't get to be head of a big syndicate until you learn to do things slowly and very carefully. Otherwise, somebody might kill you first.
So you're Nem Gibb. Us boys down at the bottom never get to see a big shot like you.
Too bad. I don't have much time to get around.
All right, let's can the chatter. Where's the dough?
That's better. Direct and right to the point, huh? I've got the money right here.
And I've got Dick Tracy.
So I see. Well, who does what?
Take that dough out of your pocket real slow and put it on the table. I'll stand over here and cover Tracy and you while Moat counts the loot.
Okay, that's the way you want it. There it is.
Gosh, Flattop, I never saw so much money in my life. $45,000.
Moat, give me the money.
No, you don't. Not until you kill Tracy.
Damn, Kip, I've got Tracy, and now I've got the dough, too.
What are you talking about?
Just this. You raised that $45,000 pretty fast. You and your friends been making a lot of dough out of this town out of crime. If you can afford $50,000, you can afford $100,000, and that's my price.
Why, that's ridiculous.
Stay where you are, Ramkid.
Ramkid, why don't you give Flat Top the $100,000? I'm worth that much to you, Dad.
Shut up, Tracy. Flat Top, can't you see? He's only trying to start a fight between us. So you won't kill him.
Don't worry about it. I got him covered, and you too. Now get out of here. And don't come back till you got that $50,000.
Okay.
Hey, wait a minute. I got a better idea. I'm taking Tracy out of here so you can't send a couple of your hoods up here to take care of me, see?
Flat Top, will you ever grow up? Look, let me write you a check for the complete amount. I've got my checkbook right here.
Don't make a move.
It looks like you got me, Tracy.
You all right, Tracy?
Yeah.
It looks like you really did a good job. I don't know why it is, but you seem to have all the fun.
It may seem like fun to you, but believe me, I'd rather be home with Tess reading my newspaper.
I can believe that.
All right, Flat Top, let's go. Sam, you better call the coroner.